In this video, for section 36 of Hansen and Quinn's Greek and Intensive course, you'll learn to form Greek purpose clauses, which will put to good use the sequence of moods, which was the subject of the last video. And you should definitely watch that if you haven't already. Hansen and Quinn's explanation of purpose clauses is on pages 68 to 70 and in the appendix on a whole bunch of pages. Purpose clauses, known in Britain as final clauses, which caused me some confusion when I started reading British commentaries, so go ahead and know that now. Purpose clauses and final clauses are the same thing. Both of them, no matter what the name, express the idea of purpose. English does this in several ways. The most common among Americans at the moment is the English infinitive. I'm making a video to teach you Greek. To teach you Greek tells you the purpose of the action in the main clause, I'm making a video. But Attic Greek does not use infinitives for purpose. It uses a conjunction and a verb with person and number in order that I may teach you Greek. We don't use language this formal in American English right now, but it does reflect the way Greek expresses purpose in a full dependent clause. Of course, that means two words in Greek rather than the six that we have to do that in English. So how does Greek do it? First, you need the conjunction. Hina, hos, or hapos are the Greek conjunctions for in order that. You pick one of those and add a verb in either the subjunctive or the optative mood, and you decide which mood you're going to put it in according to the sequence of moods. And just for reference, I'll put the chart of sequence of moods right down here. But I'll also remind you that in primary sequence, you choose subjunctive for purpose clauses, and translate in order that she may verb. I told you when I introduced the subjunctive that I give you default translations when we introduce each way to use the subjunctive, and so here's your first one. The subjunctive in a purpose clause in primary sequence is in order that she may verb. If we need secondary sequence, if the main verb is in tense of the past, then we will use the optative for purpose clauses, and we will translate in order that she might verb. So that's your first default translation for an optative. A negative purpose clause uses may for the negative and usually puts it right after the conjunction. So hina may, hos may, or hapos may. Each of which can be translated in order that not, or in a convenient but slightly archaic word, lest. So let's see this in action. We're going to try putting this sentence into Greek. We send gold in order that y'all may sacrifice animals. First the main clause, we send gold, which becomes pempomen kruson. Now we need the conjunction. Hina is my favorite, so I'm going to use that, but you could replace it with hos or hapos as you like, and it would mean the same thing. Now we have the actual purpose clause, but remember that we need to decide what mood to put the verb in according to the sequence of moods. So that means we need to look at the verb of the main clause, which is pempomen. That's present, so if we look down in our little chart, we can see that we need the subjunctive mood for the purpose clause because we're in primary sequence. And so our Greek is thueta zoa, in order that y'all may sacrifice animals. This is present subjunctive, which can mean may sacrifice or may be sacrificing if you need to stress in English the progressive aspect. You can do the same sentence with the aorist subjunctive if it's simple aspect, and it's y'all may sacrifice. And that's your first purpose clause. Let's try another. we will send gold in order that y'all may sacrifice animals. So here's the main clause. We will send gold, which is pempsomen kruson. We need our conjunction, and I'm going to use hinna again. And now the actual purpose clause. We need to decide again what mood we're going to put that verb in by looking at the main verb. This time, it's the future tense, which, according to our chart, means we'll use the subjunctive because we're in primary sequence. And so, again, it's theta zoa. If we did it in the subjunctive aorist, it would be theta zoa. And those are practically interchangeable for the purpose clause here. If you have a context that really stresses simple aspect for the aorist tense or progressive repeated aspect for the present tense, then you need to care which is which. But most of the time, they're pretty interchangeable. Now, I want to let you in on a little secret about decoding Hansen and Quinn. Look at the English helping verb may. Hansen and Quinn always translate primary sequence purpose clauses, the subjunctive ones, with the helping verb may. So if you see the subjunctive in a purpose clause, you can reliably translate it as may verb. And vice versa, if you see may verb in an English to Greek sentence you're supposed to translate, you can reliably translate that as the subjunctive and know by that little shortcut that you're in primary sequence. Okay, let's try another purpose clause. We sent gold in order that y'all might sacrifice animals. The main clause, we sent gold, is epempsamen kruson. I'm going to use my favorite again, hinna, for the conjunction. And then we have to do the purpose clause. Of course, that means looking at the main verb and seeing what tense it is so that we can decide according to the sequence of moods. This time it's aorist, and so if we look down in our chart, we'll see that this time we need the optative for the purpose clause because we're in secondary sequence. And so the present optative is going to be theta zoa. But you can do the same sentence with the aorist optative, theta zoa, and both of them will mean in order that y'all might sacrifice animals. If you really need to stress progressive repeated accent, aspect, use the present tense. If you really need to stress simple aspect, use the aorist tense. Now, back to Hansen and Quinn's secrets. Look this time at the helping verb might. Hansen and Quinn always translate secondary sequence purpose clauses, the optative ones, with the helping verb might. So if you see the optative in the purpose clause, translate it as might verb. And vice versa, if you see might verb in an English sentence you're meant to translate into Greek in Hansen and Quinn, you can reliably choose the secondary sequence and the optative. One thing that helps me remember these little tricks, the I in might reminds me of the iotas in all the optatives. So when I see a purpose clause with the optative, I remember to translate in order that she might verb. Let's try going the other way. Here's a Greek sentence for us to translate. First, I see the hinna, which tells me I'm going to be dealing with a purpose clause. And the part of the sentence after the conjunction is the purpose clause. Keep all of that together. Translate the main clause first. We were sending gold is a good translation of epempomen kruson. Then the conjunction, in order that. And then look at the verb of the purpose clause and decide whether it's subjunctive or optative and what sequence we're in. Remember your Hansen and Quinn tips if that helps. And add person and number to translate correctly. Hinna thuoita zoa becomes in order that y'all might be sacrificing animals. Now that translation stresses the progressive repeated aspect in the present optative that we see there. But most of the time, in order that y'all might sacrifice animals is what English would say. A little extra training here. If I ask you to give the syntax of theoita, you identify all the things you can about that verb, and then you explain that it's in the mood it's in because of the kind of clause it's in, and then why it's optative and not subjunctive, and then why it's in secondary sequence because of the imperfect in this case. To be totally thorough, you'll explain why it's in the tense that it is. So if I ask you the syntax of theoita, you might tell me that it's the present optative second person plural. You might also add that it's active, and that it's optative in a purpose clause in secondary sequence after the imperfect main verb epempomen. You might also tell me that it's present tense because of progressive repeated aspect. Let's try a more different sentence. Hopos me pause hodemos ton polemon dora pempsusi te boule. So, we've got hopos, and that means it's a purpose clause, and we can be pretty sure that everything up to the comma is part of the clause. Just as in English, Greek purpose clauses can come at the beginning of a sentence, so don't be thrown by that. You'll notice that there's a me, too, so we're going to start translating in order that and make sure that we remember the not, but I'm leaving a little bit of space because we'll need a few more English words before it. We find the nominative of the clause, this time it's the purpose clause, and we translate the people, and then the verb of the clause, which we see is subjunctive, so we'll translate may stop. And then we need the direct object and the accusative, ton polemon, and that is the war. And with the comma, the purpose clause is done, in order that the people may not stop the war. The subject and verb of the main clause are both in pempsusi. They will send, which needs a direct object, dora, bribes, which just leaves the dative indirect object to the council. At this point, you can double check. Does the helping verb in English match the mood that the main verb calls for by sequence of moods? They will send is good for future, primary sequence, subjunctive, may, we're all good. Okay, so last one. Here we have a Greek sentence. Biblion peri tes erenes egrapsen hos ton adelphon paideoi. You see the hos, so we've got a purpose clause, which goes to the end of the sentence. The subject and verb of the main clause are both in egrapsen. She wrote. We need a direct object, a book, and look, a prepositional phrase, which is peri tes erenes, about peace. And now the purpose clause. In order that is nice for hos. Now, here you may be tempted to say to in English, because that English infinitive is often how we express purpose these days. But infinitives do not have person and number, and so you'd be missing things that the Greek is telling you that you should capture in English. So don't do it. Don't use an English infinitive. Don't use to. Our verb here is paideoi, which is optative, and so we're in the secondary sequence, which means we can count on the helping verb might. And we get, she might educate. And the direct object is the brother. So we have here, she wrote a book about peace in order that she might educate her brother. You can double check that optative secondary sequence sounding English with the main verb, which is aorist, and does in fact belong to the secondary sequence. So now you've matched it up, you've double-checked, you've done your due diligence about purpose clauses, and you can go and have fun translating them.